mentioned Yuval Harari and some of the work that he's done. I always quote from his book Sapiens, if you've read it.
Yes.
And in that first chapter, he really talks about what is unique about humans versus the other animals in the animal kingdom. And he focuses on one feature, thing that we do, which is tell stories, right? This consensus, sense-making algorithm that we have, which starts with ideas and goes into language and then into communication. Now it's digitized, so it's global. But these stories that we tell each other, that is our superpower as humans. That's what's allowing us to build these buildings, because we tell each other stories and we believe in those stories, and then we work together on those things, like buildings are good, we want to live vertical. You know, some of the oldest stories we have as humans are religion. What is God or goddess? How was the earth created? These are aligning stories that have gotten us to where we are in many ways. And one of the grandest stories that we have as humans is the story of money.
Sure.
Why we have it, why we need it, what it does, what it gives us in society, what access it gives us. And what's so interesting to me about this time in life and this time in our industry is it seems like we have the opportunity to retell this story or tell the next chapter of this story, which is, you know, money has been like so for a certain amount of time, a long amount of time, and it hasn't always been the same. It's changed from, you know, gold and minerals and salt and oil and things we could touch to fiat currencies and the digitization of those currencies and also the financialization of those currencies. But it's been as it's been until now. How should it be moving forward? How can it be in the future? And that's really where the work of, you mentioned Bernard Lyotard, who was the president of the Bancorp Foundation until a month ago when he passed away. And his work really got me and yourself and other people thinking about what's the next story of money? What's the future of money? Does it have to keep coming from these, you know, individual pockets in society, or can it come from everywhere? The way we think about information used to come from the king, right? Or from the emperor. And then information came from the government. And then information came from the newspapers and from the TV broadcasting stations. And today information comes from a lot of places, right? And that's one of the most beautiful and also complex things about the internet, is that the information, the amount of information has increased tremendously. As with all technologies, there's good things about that, there's hard things about that. But when we look at the story of money, money has come from the earth in its oldest iteration, and then it's come from the governments, or, you know, the kings or the presidents or the central banks or the Federal Reserves in this iteration. And in the next iteration, what we see, just like with information, is money coming from the people. Who are the people? The people who made Bitcoin, the people who made Ethereum, the people who made Bancor, the people who will make hearts moving forward in the future, people like you and me, people like you guys out there, that's where money will come from. And that's what we're really, really excited about.